sidechain device sends its audio signal to an effect that's in a different track or sampler effects chain. This allows the receiving effects behaviour to be controlled by an audio source other than the one that it's actually processing.
Just so you know, although some VST plugins manage to hack some form of sidechaining, they're not guaranteed to work since this function was never officially supported until VST 3. So, if you're able, you should use the later version of those plugins.
The signal follower achieves its sidechaining through parameter modulation. See its video for full details on that. And it can connect to any available effect. However, the sidechain device can only connect to effects that have separate control and processing inputs. If an effect can be sidechained, then in the top right area, you'll see this icon, which changes colour to show that a connection has been established. The available native devices are the compressor, the bus compressor, and the gate. This is because of the way they work, which involves measuring the input signal against a threshold control, and that decides when the effect is activated. What the sidechain device is doing is replacing the effect's original control input with the audio signal routed from the source. Since the signal follower does not do this, and instead directly modulates the parameters, it is, generally speaking, not as well suited for controlling these types of effects. Something to be aware of is that third-party effects will mostly use a sidechained signal in the same way as the native devices. But some of them will use the input to automate parameters like the signal follower does, while others will operate the sidechain like a send device to route audio for use in the actual effect processing. Now let's take a look at the controls. The most important parameter of the sidechain is the receiver, where you choose the destination track and device. In the audio process pipeline, tracks are processed in a strict order of left to right. So the track that the receiver device is in must be to the right of the track that the sidechain is in. Sampler effects chains are processed vertically, top to bottom, so there, the receiver must be below the sidechain. And so, if you want to target a device that currently appears before the sidechain, then you'll need to reorder the tracks or sampler effects chains so that this is no longer true. An important point to note here is that it's actually possible to route more than one sidechain to the same receiver, in which case the signals will be added together. Useful if you'd like to control that device with audio from different tracks or even from different points in the same track. Which brings us to the mute keep source option. The default setting is keep source, which allows the audio to continue playing through the effect chain after it's routed to the receiver. Choosing mute source will silence the audio instead. since effect chains are processed from left to right, with each effect feeding into the next, thus affecting the audio. The exact placement of a sidechain device can be a crucial factor in transmitting the appropriate signal. And this is especially true when keep source is selected, with multiple sidechains in the same effect chain. With the amount slider, you can adjust the volume level of the audio signal that is sent to the receiver. Panning sets the balance for how much of the left and right channels are sent. This can have implications depending on both the stereo nature of the audio that's sent and how the receiving effect is set up to respond to the stereo channels. You can experiment with sidechaining different types of effects to create your own novel production techniques. However, by far the most popular usage is for sidechain compression. If you're unfamiliar with this, it's the reduction of a musical element's volume, which is done in response to something else in the music. Typically, the aim is to always keep one or more elements clearly audible no matter what else is playing, which can be very important for particularly busy music. This can be used in a more natural, subtle way for lead instruments and vocals, or applied heavily for percussion to create the familiar bass pumping sound.